Hey guys, today we are going to start working on a new project. It is a social network app built with Laravel 8, Inertia, Jetstream, Tailwind, and a few other packages that I pulled in to do different things. Let's take a look and see what we got. Okay, so authentication, it's Jetstream using Fortify. I left everything pretty much default. I did change a couple of things, but it's very simple. The only things I added were username and a gender field. So let's go ahead and create a user and see what it looks like. Test 2, username, test 2. Email test2@test.com. Oops. Password is password. And gender, it's the automatic default. I put it on female, but you can select anyone you want. Or create more, however you want to do it. It's up to you. It's yours. Okay. So now the first thing we have, it's the dashboard. Now this package uses Ziggy to handle our routes, and it would normally go to dashboard as the default route, but I added the prefix user to most of the routes involving the user information. Okay, so here we have a place where you can post. You can click on any of the suggested user. All I did was just, when you highlight it, you can see their usernames and just click in and add them or whatever you want to do. So on the dashboard, this will hold, hang on. Let's open up. I have another one open up here so we can see both, the differences in both. Okay, so this is what, on the left side, what your dashboard would look like. It'll have posts that you make and posts that your friends make all listed, kind of like on Facebook, where your homepage is your friends' posts, yours and your friends' posts. So before we get to that, what I want to do is this default image. This isn't the standard one that comes with the Laravel Jetstream install. I added a custom one. I'll show you how to do that. It's really easy to change. But what you would do is you would go to profile. You can select a new photo. Okay, let's try this one. And then save. And Laravel made this really easy to do. If you've ever tried to handle image uploads with Laravel, and let's say Vue JS, it could be a bit tricky, but they made it super simple. You don't really have to do anything else to it. So as you can see, it changed here, here, and here, wherever we have the profile image posted. This is actually really cool. I didn't change anything, maybe just a little bit of the design, but I did add the new fields that we have, the gender field and the username, so those can be updated and changed if you want. You can update your password. There's two-factor authentication. You can log out of other devices, which is pretty cool. They've got a very full, you know, Fortify is really full package. Put with Jetstream, it's really a very powerful package. You can also delete your account, which I tried today and it works really well. I didn't change, like I said, anything else really for authentication. I wanted to keep it as simple as possible. So let's go back to dashboard. And so let's try to post something. And then click post. Now, few things. Spinner, it's an epic spinner. I'll show you where to download those. I just wanted to see how they worked. A lot of the packages I brought in, this is made with Sweet Alert too. A lot of the stuff I brought in, I just wanted to see how well it worked with Inertia, because Inertia doesn't make API requests to the back end like it did, like it would with just a regular Vue.js installer. Works with Laravel routes to handle all of our routing. Okay, so as you can see, now you have this here. A couple of cool things. You can like it, or you can dislike it. And you can also comment, which works the same as the post up here. Another thing I added was a feature for you to be able to delete your own post. Okay, so that's pretty much it with that. Let's look at this one, because this one has a bit more stuff to it. What I did was, instead of having a pagination with buttons, I added in an infinite scroll, which works really well, as you can see. So if you have a lot of records in the database, it'll just load up for you instead of having those buttons. I never really like the buttons. I think they're a bit outdated, so I wanted to try something different. Okay, so that's the dashboard. If you go to the profile page, it's sort of the same thing, where you can post, and any, you know, friend that you have can also post on your page, but you can't do it because we're not friends. We won't be able to post on each other's stuff unless we had a friendship. Okay, so that's this edit profile. Links to the same one as this one. So it's the same thing. I just added it here for easier access. The other thing that I added were the icons. All of the icons that we have are from Font Awesome, and I came across a really cool way to do it by another YouTuber, and it worked really well. I'll show you that. I saw it. I thought it was pretty cool, and it's better than installing all of Font Awesome's, you know, awesomeness. You can just install what you want. You can just download what you need and just use them. Just use the SVGs. So I'll get to that later once we get to it. But that's what's going on here with these as well. These are also the Font Awesome icons. Okay, so then there's the friends section. You'll be able to see anyone who sent you a request that you haven't added yet. And you can also see your list of friends. So let's go ahead and try to, same picture. Okay, I guess it was for another test. Okay, so let's go to members here, and then we'll go to this is this user on the left side. Okay, so now here you'll see we have an add friend button. So we click that. Now again, in Epic Spinner, what we're doing is we are going to be using the Laravel notifications to send emails, as well as a notification that you'll see pop up in a second. Again, sweet alert. Okay, now we have the notification, and now it's listed here. So a few things here. We have a mark all as red, so you can mark all of them red at one time. You can have unread. These are the red, sorry, the notifications you've already read, and this is the new one. So you can see there's a difference in the highlighting. I'd never used Tailwind, so I was kind of playing around with some of the things on there. So this is a button. You can also delete the notification. And up here, I'll show you, we're going to be using Mailtrap to handle all our mailables. So this is the email, super simple, but you can flesh it out, do, you know, basically however, whatever you want to do with it. Okay. So let's click it. And this will take us to our friend requests page. Okay, now you can accept, you can ignore. Now, I don't know, I always like the idea of having an ignore feature. You don't have to add it, but I think it's good. You know, you can just ignore the person without raising too many flags or getting, I don't know. It's just something that I thought would be good to do. I'm a big fan of putting things that you don't want to happen and being able to customize your stuff. You don't want everybody asking you for a friend request and then you feeling obligated to add them or whatever. You can just go ahead, ignore them, and it'll just clear out the relationship. So let's go ahead and add accept and Epic Spinner. Okay, another sweet alert. Now our new friend test2 will have a notification. Or should. Just make sure there's nothing wrong. I did make sure to test on all of these, on most of our functionality here, just to make sure, but there, because Laravel and Inertia, that whole setup been updating, it's going through constant updates. Some things might be a little bit glitchy, but there it is. There's our notification. For the instant notifications, we're using Laravel Echo with Pusher. Sorry, I forgot. Okay, so now again with the member section. Now these pages where there will be a lot of records in the database, I did add that infinite scroll. I made it into a component, a VJS component, so that you can use it anywhere that you need to. So here's a whole list of all the users, and you'll be able to see how that infinite scroll works. You see, it just adds new ones, new records to the bottom as you scroll down. Okay, another cool thing that I've been working with, and I got it mostly working how I wanted to, but for the purposes of the demo, it works just fine. Okay, so you can join a chat room. It'll show you all the active members. And let's say our new friend also wants to join the chat room. Join the chat room. And as you can see, it updates the users. Okay, it updates the users immediately. So we have two active users, and then we have a whole chat section. Again, it's with Laravel and Echo, so it works pretty instantaneously. So let's say here, I type in hi. And it'll show up immediately here, and it'll show up immediately here, and the same thing on this side. Now, the other thing too is this button here, this sort of disabled action, is something that I just found out that they kind of fixed, because Tailwind didn't really have a good way of handling the disabled. So I wanted to try this out to see how it works. I don't know how I feel about it yet. I usually will do, when I was working on this, I had my own sort of making it unclickable or whatever, but they did a pretty good job where you can click it as many times as you want and it won't send anything else. Okay. So now to go back here, let's say we go back to the chat rooms. This is a nice setup. What you can do is also something I was thinking about working out in another project that I'm planning on doing that will include a chat rooms feature, is to make it so that a user can create their own chat room and maybe have it time out if nobody's in there for, let's say, an hour or something, and then it'll delete the chat room. But again, that's something, once I show you how to do this, you'll be able to implement it. The other thing, the problem that I've been having was, and maybe someone else can help me with this. When I exit the chat room, it doesn't drop the number here, but for the other user it would. But if I refresh the page, it will. But again, I just tried using Laravel and Pusher, so it could just be my ignorance and knowing how to use it. So if someone knows how to use the presence channel to make this go back to zero when a user leaves, then by all means, just put it in the comments and I'll take a look and try to add it in and have it fixed before we finish, you know, when we get to that point. But what I'm going to be doing along the way is also posting as we go along. I'll be posting from each of the episodes, I'll be posting the GitHub code to GitHub, so you guys will be able to take a look, and anything that you feel that you could help with, that would be great. So we can all just kind of help each other and kind of learn from each other. Anyway, the next episode we'll be setting up our project with all the installs of things that we'll need. So I guess I'll see you then.